Today's video is in collaboration with Idealist Sweden. Good morning everyone, it's Carter from Cabin Crew Chat and I'm so excited to finally share my first Get Ready With Me morning routine as a flight attendant. This morning I'm getting ready for a multi-sector flight from Brisbane to Sydney, then Sydney to Perth. I'm not at all a morning person, so I usually set about 5 alarms on my phone. It seems ridiculous, but it's better to be safe than sorry. When I finally do decide to get up, I switch on all the lights in my bedroom to make sure that I won't be tempted to go back to sleep. And knowing myself, I definitely would go back to sleep, especially when it's so early in the morning that the sun is not fully up. And here I am, clearly struggling. Is anyone else like this or is it just me? And because I am blind as a bat, I need my glasses before I can do anything. First thing first, I like to start the day by drinking a lot of water to keep my body hydrated and kickstart my metabolism. So that's why I keep a big bottle of water beside my bed. As a flight attendant, it's so important to keep up with any changes in flight operations and services, so I check my work email and websites straight up before my flights. And of course, a bit of cheeky Instagram. Make sure to follow me if you haven't. Because this is an overnight trip, I want to make my bed as tidy as possible so that I can come home to a nicely made bed, ready to rest up. It's going to be a red-eye flight heading back from home from Brisbane to Perth, so I definitely will be exhausted working through it tonight without any sleep. It's always so refreshing to come home to a made bed, so I always go the extra mile in the morning. Growing up in a Japanese household, I always had showers at night, but getting up this early in the morning, taking a shower helps me wake up and get ready for the day mentally as well. I also prefer washing my hair in the morning to get rid of any bedhead, especially with thick Asian hair. It can be difficult to get rid of bedhead with just a hairdryer. Work days, I like wearing a white singlet underneath my uniform. I put in my contacts. I find putting contact lenses in so early in the morning so difficult. And then of course, I need to get rid of my beard to look presentable in the uniform. For my thick, stubborn Asian hair, I find putting on pre-styling hairspray helps with molding my hair into a perfect style. I spread it onto my towel dry hair and follow it up with blow dryer and a round brush to style it. For hair wax, I use a clay. I personally prefer the matte finish because it looks very natural, like you don't have any products in. I start at the back of my head and work my way to the front, paying extra attention to my parting. Okay, time for skin. In the morning, I love using a gentle cleanser because it washes off any dirt and excess oil that built up during the night, but doesn't overstrip the skin. Spending so much time up in the air can be so rough on your skin, so it's important for cabin crew to maintain a regular skincare to help keep their skin hydrated. I will be making a full separate skincare routine video with every product I use, so don't worry if you miss any products. I then gently pat dry my face with a clean face towel. I fold that up with a hydrating toner and pat it in gently. Pat, 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 pat. I like to switch up my serums depending on my skin condition that day. And I always put on sunscreen before going outside to protect myself against both UVAs and UVBs and prevent sunspots and wrinkles. Finishing up on skincare, it's time for the uniform. I make sure to steam my uniform the night before the flight to save time in the morning, saving as much time for a few extra minutes of sleep. Today's pretty warm, so I'll be wearing a short sleeve shirt. The uniform is altered to every individual for clean look. During training, I had a fitting day and the uniform was adjusted for me. For men's uniform, we wear a lilac tie, and for safety reasons, the tie is a clip-on, which makes it much easier to put on. It also saves a ton of time too. The back of the waistcoat is a plum tone, which complements the tie. My father's favorite color was purple, so he would have loved seeing me in my uniform. And now for my favorite part of the uniform, because this is the only part we get to personalize. Sushi socks. As part of our dress code, we expected to wear one of the approved designs of shoes, and these actually took me ages to find. It's true that breakfast is one of the most important meals of the day, but with such a tight schedule, it can be difficult to find the time to eat. So sticking with a few staple breakfasts that are quick and easy to prepare is always helpful. Today I made avocado toast with salt and black pepper, and toast with peanut butter and a drizzle of honey. If I had time, I would have made an egg with avocado toast too, but no time today. I've been loving peanut butter with a little honey drizzled on top. My favorite peanut butter is made with dark roasted smooth peanut butter, which has no added oil, salt, or sugar. So a bit of extra sweetness from a sliced banana or a drizzle of honey makes for a great brekkie. I would usually put sliced bananas on top, but I accidentally ate my last banana the night before. Let me just take a quick Insta story before I eat my breakfast. I found a lot of peace in the morning. Almost like the calm before the storm of a hectic workday. The quiet gives me time to think, but it's usually interrupted by the sound of crunchy toast. Food is my meditation. There's nothing better than eating a good plate of food before a full day of work. When my phone rings, that's usually an indicator that my time to get ready is slowly drawing to an end and that it's time to leave. But today, the crew called me to let me know that the flight has been delayed, but that's a normal part of the job. Just before I leave, I choose a cologne for my collection, depending on my mood, and give myself a subtle spritz. Today, I'm going with Allure by Chanel. Subtlety is a crucial element to choosing a cologne to wear whilst on board, because a strong cologne can travel. Finishing up before I leave, I double check my crew bags to make sure I have everything I need for my overnight trip. Each flight attendant will have a trolley bag filled with everything they need for an overnight stay, and an esky bag that slides onto the handle for easy access, filled with the essentials. Here I am packing some snacks for the long flight to Perth. Flight attending can be very physically demanding at times, so I'm packing a few snacks for a quick energy boost during my breaks. And here is how I look today. Of course, as a flight attendant, I can't forget my watch. And with that, I'm prepped and ready for a long domestic flight. Thanks to today's collaboration with Ideally Sweden, I have a 15% discount for you for staying till the very end of the video. Make sure to use the link below and use my discount code at checkout. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.